Hello, everybody. This may be a bit of a surprise for everybody, but we are going to be playing through Assassin's Creed 1 because, as it turns out, Sayuri is such a horse lover. She started with the first game that featured horses, although there are actually horses in this game.
There are.
Yes, there are.
Damn it.
But we figured we might as well play through the entire series then, and we'll be picking off on the other games where we left them, or we may be restarting them. We're not sure how we're going to do that yet, but we're going to play this part anyway. In addition to that, we also have a very sick person here.
Oh, sorry.
So we'll do our best in cutting out the sniffing and the coughing and the other stuff, but you might be hearing something, and of course the very sexy voice.
It's not. Shut up.
In addition to that, we switched mics because of editing and echoes, so we hope this setup will work out better for us. So let's start the game. We'll make a new game. And there should be subtitles.
I applied my heart to know wisdom, and to know madness and folly. I perceived that this also was a chasing after wind.
Those girls are annoying.
Yeah, very annoying.
And he has increased knowledge. Sorrow.
I've got a problem. I can't anchor him to the net.
See, were there options for blood is on, vibrations on? Thought I had turned on. Oh well. There's supposed to be subtitles in here, but we'll figure that out later.
Memory. Too much psychological trauma. He's rejecting the treatment. Retreating.
Desmond, I need you to try and relax.
Let me try and stabilize.
Now focus.
You can punch people.
Cool.
Recognize that what you're seeing isn't real. Just a picture of the past. It can't hurt you.
They're running away.
Give it a moment, Mr. He'll adjust. The first time is never easy.
So confusing.
Yeah.
That's enough, Mr.
You're being punched.
We need to pull him out. Now.
All right.
Blah, 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 blah.
We're going to try and bring you out.
Yeah, I can climb.
That was weird.
You okay?
I told you he'd be fine.
Bastards!
Now, I just saved your life.
Saved my life? You kidnapped me. You strapped me into that thing.
Animus. It's an animus.
I don't even know you people. Why are you doing this to me?
You have information we need, Mr. Miles.
Information? I'm a bartender, for Christ's sakes. What do you want me to do, teach you how to mix a martini?
We know who you are. What you are.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play coy with me. There isn't time. You're an assassin. And whether you realize it or not, you've got something that my employers want. Locked away in that head of yours.
But I'm not an assassin. Not anymore.
Yes, your file indicated as much. Something about an escape. Most fortunate for us.
What do you want from me?
For you to do as you're told. The Animus will allow us to locate what we need. Once we have it, you'll be free to go.
I am not going back in there.
Then we'll induce a coma and continue our work. When we're done, you'll be left to die. Truth be told, the only reason you're still conscious is because this approach saves us time.
You're insane.
So what is it, Mr. Miles? Live or die? Lie down.
No, I don't want to lie down yet. Dang it.
You have no choice.
Yep.
Where am I?
You're inside the Animus.
Which is?
It's a projector that renders genetic memories in three dimensions.
Genetic memory?
Seems you'll need a bit of a tutorial. Very well. We'll start simple. What is a memory, Mr. Miles?
It's the recollection of a past event.
Specific to the individual remembering the event.
Yeah, sure.
What if I told you that the human body not only housed an individual's memory, but the memories of his ancestors as well? Genetic memory, if you will. Migration, hibernation, reproduction. How do animals know when and where to go? What to do?
That's just animal instinct.
Now you're arguing semantics, Mr. Miles. Whatever you call it, the fact remains. These creatures hold knowledge absent the requisite first-hand experience. I've spent the past 30 years trying to understand why. I discovered something most fascinating. Our DNA functions as an archive. It contains not only genetic instructions passed down from previous generations, but memories as well. The memories of our ancestors.
And the Animus lets you decode and read these DNA files.
Precisely.
But there's a problem. This is the specific memory we're trying to access. Unfortunately, when we try and open the memory, your mind withdraws. You lack the confidence to step into your ancestor's body. That's what happened earlier. You got knocked out of the target memory and pushed back to a more stable state.
Why?
It's your subconscious. It's resisting. We found similar reactions among patients who undergo hypnosis to relive traumatic events. They can't jump directly into the specific memory. They need to be eased in. Even then, there can be problems.
So how do we fix it?
We find a memory you can synchronize with, and we move forward from there. You'll get used to it. This is the closest we can get, so it's where we'll have to start. I'm uploading the tutorial program now.
Warning. Data stream unstable. Attempting to restore synchronization. Hello, Subject 17. This tutorial has been prepared in order to better acclimate you to the Animus's control system. Instructions will follow shortly. The synchronization bar represents how in sync you are with your ancestors' memories. If you ever fall completely out of sync, the Animus will restore you to your last synchronized position. You are currently dangerously close to desynchronization. Please follow all forthcoming instructions in order to restore system stability.
Yeah, sure.
The Animus utilizes a puppeteering concept to control the actions of your ancestor. I'm loading subroutines to validate your body's adaptation to the Animus. We will begin by exploring the default actions of each input. While standing still, use the head button to observe your environment. Good.
Yay.
Okay.
This is so simple.
Without causing them to drop what they're holding.
Wait, for the first time, run into them. Just for fun.
To continue the synchronization process.
I wanna run. Whee!
Aw, no chain reaction. I was hoping for a domino. Oh well.
Too bad. This is so easy.
We'll move through and then.
Walk. Go away. finally.
Not sure why you were touching them, though.
Well done.
Not sure where you were touching them.
I don't know, and I don't
the
care.
Animus differentiates between two fundamental actions. Low profile and high profile. Low profile actions are socially acceptable. High profile actions are more action oriented. Hold the high profile button to see how your heads up display changes the context of the puppeteering inputs.
Right trigger.
Oh, this
yeah,
one.
Yeah, trigger.
Just kidding.
Excellent.
Finally.
Shut up.
We will continue your synchronization process by testing some high-profile actions. Grab and throw this individual onto the marker by using the empty hand button in high profile. Good.
Yay.
Easy.
So for every tutorial we get a bar.
High profile will allow you to sprint.
Eight more.
Sprinting is useful to escape from soldiers or to get closer to a fleeing target.
Run.
However, be careful not to
bump
into anyone.
Hurry up, we're talking.
And tumble to the ground. While sprinting, reach the marker before this man does.
Okay.
Yay.
Slowpoke.
The Animus will also provide other important information. The social status icon gives you information on your social status. The different states will be explained in context soon. This icon appears when a soldier is looking at you. The yellow color means the soldier is either unaware or suspicious of who you are. To illustrate the change in awareness level, you will stealth assassinate this soldier. First, lock onto your target. Now, select your hidden blade.
The what?
D-pad up. Yep.
This one.
Now you're forced to use it.
Damn it.
Assassinate him by using your armed hand button.
I did nothing.
Damn! Where are you? I know you're here somewhere.
The dead body has alerted the soldier and changed his awareness to informed, as represented by the red witness indicator. Aggressive actions or socially unacceptable behavior undertaken at this time will likely provoke an armed response. Provoke this soldier.
Stop the
Notice how the social status icon has changed to exposed. Use the ladder and try to break the line of sight.
Nice move.
Excellent. The line of sight has been broken. Now run into the roof garden to hide from the soldier. Good. Your social status indicates that you are hidden, but the soldier is still looking for you. Wait until your social status changes again.
You do well to hide.
Well done. The soldier has lost your track. You are now anonymous, and you can exit the hide spot. Excellent.
That was funny.
Being anonymous will fill your synchronization bar and make your job as an assassin easier. There are different places which you can use to hide. However, you must always break the line of sight first, and then use a hide spot to vanish.
Okay.
Let us continue with a demonstration of Blend. Blend can be activated with the passive use of your legs. You can mimic a scholar and pass near soldiers without arousing suspicion. Use this to reach the marker behind the soldiers.
Oh, okay.